Good morning, everybody. It is Tabata Tuesday. So we're getting about ready to get started here in a couple of minutes. I got Jill here with me, helped me out this morning. So I posted the list, Matt, something at least with a little bit of height so you can toe tap on it. Pillows work if you stack them on top of each other. That, you can make that happen. Some medium to heavy weights if you've got them. And we'll be back in about 30 seconds because my watch says 8:30. We're gonna get started here in just a few minutes.
Drop the right knee down towards the left, let's move to the left knee.
other side. So right foot back, rotate to the left. Left foot back, rotate to the right. Okay, here for just a moment. Come back to center. Slide that back foot forward. Grab that ankle. Stand tall. You know it, we're already into the stretch. Oh my gosh.
Really bouncing.
Whoa! Alright, so when you point out balancing, that's kind of that's what it is. Yeah. Take the same heel forward, drop that heel down, move the chest and shoulders toward the toe, use that opposite leg for some stability and support. Ooh, nice and easy, you're gonna take that toe down, hold it. Now if you want to bring that toe back up and back down, that's totally fine too. Awesome. All right. So now you're going to roll all the way up. Now the opposite foot. So if you went back to the right, you're going to step back to the left, or vice versa. Drop down into the lunge. Now you're going to rotate the opposite direction. Why? Well, because we're stretching the hip flexor a little bit, but we're also keeping the legs nice and warm and being about halfway down into that lunge. Whew. Awesome. Bring it back to center. Bring that back foot up. Balance, grab the ankle, and then you can grab a chair, a table, couch, whatever you got handy.
Ditto,
I'm focusing a little harder. All right, so big deep breath and exhale. You're gonna take that foot down and forward. Move the chest and shoulders toward that toe. Slight bend still in that knee, of course, and if you wanna take that foot down or bring it back up. You can so do. Yeah, it's also a good time to check your laces out. I mean, it's what I do. Make sure my laces are tight. All right, we are gonna bring our feet together first. Hands above the knees, pull the belly button in round, and roll all the way up, shoulders up, back and down. We're gonna start that nice, easy side to side once again. Just a nice, easy reach or push. Whatever works for you, you're gonna take those hands up. We're gonna finish this warm-up so we can get through the demo so you know what we're doing today. We're gonna reach up in 3, 2, 1, and reach up toward the ceiling.
Awesome.
We're gonna move into that boxer shuffle in 3, 2, 1. So just nice easy side to side. And back into those jumping jacks in 3, 2, 1. Excellent. Alright, so again, jumping is not an option for you. You can step out to the right, to the left. Again, whatever works for you, you're moving to some knee high knees. 3, 2, 1. Knees up nice and high. Landing nice and softly, of course. Kneeless work. If that jumping is not in the cards for you today, back into those butt kicks in 3, 2, 1. Knees back, heels back. Back into those jumping jacks in 3, 2, 1. So last of the jumping jacks, of course, of course. We're gonna move into some fast feet in 3, 2, 1. So fast feet here. Woo. All right, so just to make it interesting, we're gonna do fast feet for 4, and then we're gonna give a jump, fast feet for 4, give a jump, and then we'll move into final fast feet. Just to make, get your brains woken up. Mine needs to be woken up, I know. So here we go, 4, 3, 2, here's a jump. Fast feet, 4, 3, 2, here's a jump. And 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and wide. All right, so grab some yourself a drink of water. High fives to you, high fives to Gia. We're gonna get the demos going. We gotta get going, Hey Pam, how you doing? Whew. Lara, see you on there. Alright, demo time. There you go.
Yeah.
Been there, done that. Alright, so your first station is gonna be toe taps. Now, you've got something of height, a dumbbell, a slam ball, a couple of pillows stacked on top of each other. That's totally gonna work for you. So toe tap one or another. Again, if jumping is not an option for you, you can take that toe up Now again, if you've got a stool, step stool that's sturdy, that would be an option too. Come up over the top. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Woo! Alright, so squat and press. Now she can grab that ball if she wants to or not. So whatever you got, shoulder works, as long as they're not too heavy. Alright, so you're gonna grab that right underneath the chin. Nice easy squat, pressing all the way up. Excellent job. Now she can go as fast or slow as she wants, alright? But again, make sure you're feeling the weight shift back toward the heels and the hips are moving back. Perfect. Now if you've got a resistance band without handles, this can work too without any weight. So again, options. Alright, suitcase pressing. So we're down on the mat. Down on the mat, she's gonna look like she's going to be doing her feet and crunch up toward her knees and come all the way back there. Now, if lifting both feet are not the cards, again, one heel at a time. You can see there one side or alternate, totally up to you. We're gonna be all equal when you're in again. So if you want to stick to one side for added intensity, that would be all right. Awesome. All right, reverse plank. So we're right where you are. Fingertips toward the hips, heels dug into the floor, and squeezing those butt cheeks together to get up as nice and tall as you can. Hold them there. Awesome. All right, so you could go on the elbows if you've got wrist or shoulder issues for a reverse plank. So it works.
Still intense,
perfect. All right, so squat, jump, pulse. Now, kind of gave you a little bit of a taste of that in the warm-up. So you got a squat, jump, so up, and then you're going to pulse. One, two, jump. One, two, jump. Now you'll notice that she is landing nice and softly. If the jump, again, is not in the card, you're going to do just a calf raise or a heel lift. Perfect. So a little bit of pulse, bottom, and jump. Awesome. Again, you can grab a weight. You can use the bands on that if you've got those for options. All right. Underdog pushups. So your thumb joint is lined up directly underneath your shoulder. Elbows are tucked in toward the torso. It's like you're crawling up underneath the fence, bending the elbows. Back, starting into pike. You can bend the elbows down toward the floor, moving forward, coming up underneath the fence, and you can roll back up into pike. Perfect. Now, if you want to increase the intensity, you could go back the same way you came, but again, super, super intense move. You can work with every other one. Moving right back into that pike position is totally fine. All right, awesome. All right, we are almost done. We're almost done. Two more to go. Flutter kicks. So we're already down here, flipping on over from those underdog push-ups. Flutter kicks. Jill's keeping her feet nice and flexed again. If you have some issues with the low back, for stability and support, you can tuck those hands in a small on the back. She has her chin and shoulders lifted. Again, if this is too intense, you can take the shoulders and head all the way down and flutter kicks. Now, feet going at 45 degrees is going to decrease in any position the stress on the low back. So again, that's always an option. Awesome. Okay, so we're back up to our feet for our last station. So you can grab one weight and hold it any way you choose. So you can hold it here, you can hold it here. Now, if you've got it in your right hand, choosing to hold it in your right hand, your right foot's going back.
Right leg's going back,
yep. So it's a lunge. You're gonna come up out of the lunge and windmill to that same side. Leg back, dumbbell in that same hand. Perfect. And you're still windmilling and tipping those shoulders toward the leg that's back. Perfect. And again, if you need to kick it up, you can move down into the lunge and still windmill toward the side of that leg that's back. Perfect. Awesome. So many options for you today. So hopefully you can remember at least some of them. All right. So we got 20 seconds on the station, 10 second rest. We're doing each station four times that first round. Next time, it's going to be two. So again, we can keep all things equally, even if you want to do the first two rounds on one side for some of these, like, also an option. All right. So we got toe taps here to begin with. 20 seconds on. I'm going to turn the music up a little bit and grab my timer. You can grab a little sip of water.
Ready? A big water.
Give me water. It's a good pace. You're halfway there. Woo. three, two, and one. I'm gonna take my 10 second break and move it around. Ooh, I'm feeling good. I'm happy. I can see my legs now. Alright, here we go. Three, two, one, it's go time again. Squeeze your feet and your knees together.
well, maybe one of one test. In 3, 2, 1, here we go.
In 3, 2,
One. Here we go.
Okay, see you in the back there. your workout here. 10 more seconds to go, so we're halfway there.
There. 10 more seconds to go. Breathe. 5. shake things out for when it's around. We got one more set of these. We don't have to do them again. Woo! All right, hang on. In 3, 2, 1, and let's do it. Underdog pushups. Yes. All right, settle yourself in. High position to begin with. 3, 2, and 1. Here at your mat. otherwise you, I do understand the temper in that. All right, so nice and tall. Straighten left leg out. Bring your right foot up and over. Now make sure you haven't moved that leg. Make sure your ankle and your knee are still aligned with the hip. Before you do anything, I want you to sit nice and tall. Gently pull that knee toward the left shoulder. So you got your right knee pulling it toward that left. You keep going. I'm going to turn the knee up. Music down a little bit. So I feel like I'm going. Back one with the music. Big deep breath and exhale. Awesome. All right, so you're going to bring that foot back over. The right leg is in line down with that right hip. Left leg moves up and over. Okay, now before you do anything, make sure everything's in line with the hip. Sit tall first, and then gently pull. Now if you want to add that twist, you can add that twist if you like. That works for you. If it doesn't, and you're like, I never limit for stretching right here without the twist, stay right there. Big deep breath and exhale. Give that muscle a little bit of time to adjust and relax. Now we're going to uncross our legs. We're going to lay all the way back down. You're going to bring both knees into the chest and just turn a lot back and forth here. Nice and easy, nice and easy. Whew. Both feet flat on the floor. Take both knees off to the left. Both arms are going to come across the chest to the right. Again, big deep breath and exhale. Try to get both those knees as close to the floor as possible. Now, if you've already got that bottom knee on the floor, relax that top knee into that bottom leg. Get a little bit more of a stretch. Relax the hips as best you can. Should get a little bit more of a stretch on that. One last big deep breath and exhale. You're going to bring your hands back to center first. Bring the knees back to center. If you need help with that elbow, use that elbow as the floor. Taking both of those knees out to the right, nice and easy. Bring the arms across the chest to the left. And relax with the breath. Alright, one last big deep breath and exhale. You can bring your hands back to center first. Use that elbow into the mat on the floor. You need to get those knees back to center. Okay, so listen up closely. This next move is going to be super complicated. We're going to roll right over to our belly button. I know, I'm kidding, I'm kidding. Just making sure I still have your attention. All right, bringing the hands back underneath the shoulders here. We're gonna push up to our hands and knees. Okay, we are gonna move our hands back into our shoulders. Lift the knees up into pike position. Now we are doing underdog push-ups. We are stretching down those heels toward the floor. You should feel the weight of the torso and the heel of your hands. Now, if you can link one heel of your foot down toward the floor at a time, works best for your heels better. Go right ahead and do that. Now we're going to walk our hands to our feet or our feet to our hands, whatever works best for today. We're going to soften the knees, holding the belly button in. We're going to round and roll all the way up. Get about two-thirds of the way up. We're going to give you a nice big shoulder roll up, back, and down. Take our feet up nice and wide. Big deep breath and exhale. We're going to do a couple more of these. You guys are awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Thank you for joining us so early. Oh, it was so early. Awesome. Now, inspiration for today. All right, so you don't have to be great to start. Start to be great. Woo! So you guys are awesome. Made it all the way through. Jill is back here at 10:30. Back here at 10:30. So, again, another Tabata if you want to get it in for the day. You guys are awesome. We'll see you soon.